My name is Stephanie Grant. I was a captain at Express Jet Airlines, and I was a part of the first all-female African-American flight crew, and that flight happened on February 12, 2009. I knew I wanted to be a pilot when I was about 12 or 13. I was raised in Sumter, South Carolina, where Shore Air Force Base is. So I would just go out in the backyard and see the airplanes flying above. And it was something that intrigued me from the very beginning. Two gentlemen in my life, one that I've always known and one that I met later on in life. So thankfully I had an uncle that went into the Air Force and was able to share with me some of the ways that I could become an airline pilot. So initially I thought that going into the military was the only option. And then later on in life, I wasn't raised by my father, but finally when I did meet my dad and I went to a family reunion, I met a cousin on my dad's side. That cousin turned out to be Captain Herman Samuels that was a part of the first all-male African-American flight crew in the US. And I stuck to him like, you know, glue, like Velcro the entire weekend. And so between those two gentlemen, they helped me navigate everything and any questions I ever had. They were the ones that were really influential and helped me throughout the journey initially. So once I finished my military career, I was able to use my GI Bill to help offset the cost of flight training, but it still wasn't enough. So a lot of people you'll see, they will zoom through flight training and maybe because they have the financial resources. At that time, I was already in my 30s. I was married, I still had adult bills. So I had to work a 9-to-5 job and only fly at night and on the weekends, and I had to pay as I went. So it took me almost 4 years from private pilot to CFI. For me, it really was the financial portion that was the biggest obstacle initially. The advice I would give to any pilot, new and not so new, as far as having a plan B, definitely have some interest outside of flying or outside of whatever you're doing, so that in the event that in the next decade, because I've been around long enough that I experienced, a few economic downturns. So this is my second furlough. So make sure that you're able to have some different options outside of flying that you can rely on financially in the event that you can't do your plan A job, which is flying. What I love most about my career and being a pilot is the fact that I get to give back. There's not many African-American female pilots in the country. So it allows me this enormous platform to be able to share with so many other young girls that this is a career that I really want them to take an honest look at. So I'm really happy about that I've been able to make a difference in the lives of so many across the U.S. that now there's many young women that probably never would have thought of this career that are now flight students or certified flight instructors. And there are many that I've mentored that are now at the regional and even some at the major airline levels. Being one of a very few Black female pilots is not something I'm proud of. And I'm really glad to be connected with a nonprofit organization and nonprofit organizations that focus on increasing the number of Black female pilots in the U.S. So at one time, I believe when I started, I think it was less than 50. And now we've increased those numbers. I believe we're knocking on maybe the 200 mark. So we've made some strides, but we still have so much more work to be done. And we're doing the work and we're really thankful that so many people are out there supporting our efforts in order to increase the number of Black female pilots in the U.S. What I'm most grateful for today on January 11, 2021, I am most grateful for good health and family. I think if nothing over the last year has taught us that we can't buy great relationships, friendships, and health. And COVID-19 has really brought that home for me. So I'm really grateful, even though I'm not flying right now, it has allowed me the opportunity to spend enormous quality time with my family, being able to get really close to people and talk to them on different platforms other than texting. So I'm really, really grateful for good health, strength, and family relationships, and also organic friendships.